Dude, that game was fantastic!
Yeah? How would you know?
What do you mean, how would I know? I watched the game with you.
You sat with me, but you were on your phone the entire time looking at trade stuff.
But no!
Name one thing that happened in that game.
Matthews got a couple goals?
That's a lucky guess.
Did he actually? I mean, you owe me an apology.
Let's go!
Give me what I want!
Kick down the door!
Drew, you are not doing this!
What the?
Not nice!
There's a giant head!
You hear yourself?
I made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Victory, Puppy Ziggy! You gotta be like Giordano. You gotta be like Giordano. Oh, yeah! Good job. I got left hanging by a golden noodle. Okay.
Turns out a lot can change in less than 2 months. Leafs win! 5-1 over the Seattle Kraken, which is just really fun to say. January 5th, the Kraken came to Toronto and beat the Leafs 5-1. That is about as bad a loss as the Leafs have had all season, especially at home. Leafs go all the way to Seattle and deliver them their own home beating. Except, holy cow, Leafs fans on the West Coast, I gotta give you extra props. I got a few videos from people who were at the game. I cannot believe how many Leafs fans were there. Maybe I shouldn't be surprised on account of Leaf fans do that everywhere, but like at least a quarter of the building was Leaf fans. Before we talk about how they got to that 5-1 beating, think you know which way it's gonna go? Head on over to Sports Interaction. When the puck drops, Sports Interaction has you covered pregame live betting on all major sports, including baseball, which is starting up, and prop bets. Want to bet? Head over to sportsinteraction.com/SDPN and download the Sports Interaction app, but only if you're 19 years of age or older. Please play responsibly. So, full disclosure, it's past midnight at the time I'm shooting this on account of I shot a video for the SDPN YouTube channel about the Timo Meier trade and also the Tanner Jeannot trade that happened right after. If you want to check that out, head on over there. Leafs fans, you might want to stick around for the Tanner Jeannot part on account of he's on the Lightning now, and the Leafs are very likely going to play the Lightning, and also he cost 5 draft picks! How? It feels like all of Hockey Twitter was glued to our phones for the 4 or 5 hours we had to wait for the Timo Meier trade details, but if you looked up from your phone every now and then, the Leafs dominated the Kraken. Now, it didn't start that way. The Kraken got the 1-0 lead. The Leafs' top pair of Morgan Rielly and TJ Brody, oh, they make me nervous, man. It was just a calamity of errors and not great passes and throwing it up the middle and throwing it up to no one, and the Kraken eventually take advantage, and Vince Dunn finds himself alone. Point-blank shot on Ilya Samsonov. Goal. And right away, I'm a little concerned because not only is the top pair not doing so great on that goal, but also Samsonov just gets beat point blank. I know you don't want to give up that shot, but goalies are there to stop the shots that you didn't want to give up. And he had the one very good game last game, but it was after a couple shaky outings, and I was just like, oh no, are we getting back to that? The rest of the game was evidence that nope, no he's not. The Leafs went on to score 5 straight goals, and in fact, very shortly after the Kraken took the lead, here's how they got all 5 of them. First Leafs goal from the line centered by Ryan O'Reilly, who I still can't believe is a Leaf. John Tavares on the left wing, can't believe he's a Leaf either, and Mitch Marner. Mark Giordano, who was returning to Seattle after captaining them in their inaugural season, scores! And why does he score? Because Grubauer only got a piece of it, which I think you've heard a lot over the last year and a half. But this one, I don't blame on Grubauer. The Leafs did a great job in front of Seattle's net in this one, and you're gonna see that over the next 5 goals. Here is Ryan O'Reilly with the old-fashioned Darryl Boyce assist in front. No chance Grubauer sees any of this. It's funny, forwards that are known for their two-way play, you think, oh, good defensively. Forgetting the two part of two-way play. He's good in the offensive zone, we know that, on account of the hat trick, but you can't count on him to have a hat trick every game. This is the sort of thing you can count on him doing every game. It might not lead to a goal, but it's gonna lead to chances, it's gonna lead to defenders hating you, it's gonna lead to more open ice for Marner, more open ice for Tavares. Ooh, I know we're eventually gonna break this line up, but why? Speaking of which, the goal that gave the Leafs the lead that they would not give up was that line again! Justin Hall with the half clapper, it hits William Nylander in front, just realizing it was actually Nylander on that line in this game. Sheldon Keefe must be just living his best life, eh? Which line of destroyers should I put out now? When Nylander was battling, that's how he got a piece of the puck, but O'Reilly is right there. Tavares is right there. The puck happens to squirt to Tavares. He scores. The captain enjoying his new line mates. It's 2-1 Leafs. Now the next goal is not that line, and it's not even necessarily havoc in front, but it's the Leafs generating offense from hard work down low. Bunting was doing a great job being a nuisance in front of the Seattle net, but then the puck goes into the corner and he gets in there. So Seattle's defenders get in there. So Mitch Marner flies in there. Marner, who can attack the puck battle from the outside, poking away at it while Bunting does the grunt work. Leafs come out with the puck and Auston Matthews is there with his friend Mitch. To give you an idea of how much oxygen and attention Matthews soaks up, every player the Seattle Kraken have on the ice at the time of this goal are visible in this photo. All you can see is Bunting, Marner, and Matthews, and none of those guys scored this goal. It was Timothy Liljegren, who was wide open because of just how outclassed Seattle was by the Leafs' top line, the other one, or is this the top line and the other one is the other one? Dude, it's ridiculous, but Liljegren does not make a mistake, snipes it, 3-1 Leafs lead after one. Early in the second, Grubauer's still in the net, by the way. Leafs doing good work along the boards, Bunting and Matthews fighting for it. But the Kraken get it and they try to get it out. In comes Mitch like a thief in the night to poke the puck loose. Now here's that line doing great work in front. Bunting causing absolute mayhem, which he does when he's at his best. Auston Matthews right there at the side of the net to whack this thing in out of midair. And if it doesn't go in, look at Mitch Marner all alone. This is great work from the Leafs top line, but I mean, Seattle in this one, maybe the Leafs hard work makes their defense look soft. This is soft. This is brutal. We talk about the save percentage of a guy like Grubauer over the last year and a half. This is what he's got in front of him. They're not taking anybody, they're standing totally upright. This is soft. Matthews bangs it in, which you love to see, 4-1. And then the fifth goal is just bullying. Bunting to Marner, to Marner, to Matthews, and blah, blah, blah. How are you supposed to keep up with that? Unreal goal, Marner to Matthews, as it should be, sometimes. I mean, they all look good everywhere. 5-1, and what I said about the Seattle defense? Dude, it's a great passing play from Bunting, Marner, and Matthews. Adam Larson is doing a big old bunch of nothing here. They're not trusting their forwards to get back and help. They're not taking guys. They're not applying any pressure. The Leafs just ate Seattle alive. And when the puck was in the Leafs' end, Seattle actually generated a decent number of chances, which is maybe the concerning thing on the Leafs' end in a 5-1 win. Ilya Samsonov stood on his skull and brain after allowing that first goal. He was fantastic and made a few huge saves in this one. All the while, the Leafs' first goal scorer, Mark Giordano, in the building where he was a captain just a year ago, breaks the all-time NHL shot block record. Now, the shot block record, it's kind of a weird one. Giordano just passed Chris Russell, and we all kind of know the asterisk, which is they didn't start keeping shot blocking stats until, I don't know, I'm sure they didn't have them in the 40s. So unless someone wants to go through and watch every game ever, go through a lot of black and white beta tapes, we're never really going to know. But also, those guys weren't playing at the speed that they are today. They weren't playing 82 games in a season. And one thing that's been talked about as the difference this year for the Leafs, and they made strides in this department last year as well, they're just willing to do more than they used to be. Maybe that's a maturity thing, it's a life thing, I don't know. But this team is willing to do more than they used to. And Mark Giordano is no small part of that. You see the oldest guy on your team, the oldest active skater in the league, going out there and sacrificing his body every single night. Why aren't you? Question. Still gotta try O'Reilly as the 3C, right? Yeah? I guess? Oh, man. Dude, the Leafs' fourth line was great tonight. Achari has been a just wonderful addition. Like, I like this pointed out by Nick Richard. Alex Kerfoot, Noel Achari, and David Kampf led Leafs forwards in ice time against Seattle. Smart move by Sheldon Keefe to lighten the load on his top guys with a big lead early on in the first game of a Western road trip. Marner led the quote-unquote top six with 16 minutes of ice time. Matthews, Tavares, Nylander, and O'Reilly were all below 15 minutes. So that is a ridiculous masterclass by Sheldon Keefe. Good on him for that. But the reason I'm pointing out Achari and the Leafs' center depth is Tampa. It all comes back to Tampa. They just got Tanner Jeannot, and I was looking at where he fits in their lineup, and I just looked at that team down the middle. Point, Cirelli, Nick Paul, and Pierre-Édouard Belmar. It took me a sec. Braden Point is Braden Point. Anthony Cirelli iced the Leafs in Game 6. Nick Paul scored both of Tampa's goals in Game 7, and Belmar's just a problem. We're talking about a bottom six of, like, Jeannot, Paul, probably Ross Colton in there, and then Maroon, Belmar, Perry. All that to say, the Leafs' offense versus Tampa's offense, they're just gonna smash against each other lines 1 through 4 for 4 to 7 games. And I still don't know the answer to, are you better off spreading it out, having Matthews, Tavares, and O'Reilly all lead their own respective lines, or do you just load up and have this monster top six? I don't know the answer. And again, it comes back to, who are O'Reilly's wingers? I think the correct answer is Engvall and Kerfoot, and that's not the correct answer. Does this year feel different, or do we delude ourselves into thinking that every year? Listen, I speak my mind on this channel and on the podcast. I just say what I feel and what I see with when it comes to this team. For every criticism I have for this team, just calling it the way I see it, I think what gets lost is I still want them to win. So let's say over the next few days, the Leafs make a bunch of dumb decisions and Tampa makes a bunch of good ones. And coming out of that, I don't think the Leafs are going to beat Tampa in round one. I will still find a way to delude myself once puck drop happens in game one. I will force myself somehow to believe that they can do it. I believe they call that fandom, and there's nothing wrong with it. And last but not least, when getting dressed, left side or right side first? Like in the morning? Oh, at hockey. I've never paid attention to it because I'm bad no matter what, but I'm pretty sure it's like reading a book. I start left and I go right. Do I do that consciously? No. I just kind of do it. And then I go out there and I skate poorly and fall down. And it's great and fun, and I highly recommend it. So that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you liked this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. Brand new SDP today. We're going to have Eric Lindros on in studio. We're going to have a brand new Chris Johnston show. He's going to break everything down and lead us into trade deadline week. I got my Timo Meyer / Tanner Jeannot video up on the SDPN channel. What else? Are you not entertained? Is this not why you are here?